Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. The online chess Olympiads are in Division 1 where 40 of the best teams are divided in 4 groups. The first 3 teams of each group will play the final phase of the Olympics. In today's video, the great game Wesley So versus Daniele Vocaturo, Italian Grandmaster, played yesterday in the match between USA and Italy. Let's get started. Wesley So with the white pieces opens with e4 and Vocaturo answers with knight to f6 attacking the pawn, the Alekhine defense. e5, knight to d5, d4 conquering the center, d6 attacking the most advanced pawn, and now knight to f3 is the most solid system for white. Immediately g6, bishop to c4 attacking the knight, knight back to b6, and now is the bishop that is under attack. Bishop back to b3, bishop in fiancetto, and knight to g5, attacking with the help of the bishop f7. Now in this position, black must play e6, short castle is not the best move, because after short castle, not played by Vocaturo, it's white that will play e6 with some complications, with some advantage for white. So let's go back to our game. After knight to g5, Vocaturo continues with the right move, that is e6. Now we notice that the e5 pawn is 2 times under attack. There are 2 main continuations for white. They are f4, protecting the pawn, or the most aggressive queen to f3, played by Wesley So. Now in this position, there is the queen that of course is threatening checkmate. Again, short castle is not the bad choice. Let's watch why. Because after short castle, again not played by Vocaturo, the queen moves to h3, so there is the checkmate threat on h7. h6 or h5, let's see what happens. After h6, the knight moves back, but in any case, the h-pawn will become a target of the kingside attack, with, of course, difficult position to hold for black. Let's go back to our game. That's why after queen to f3 played by Wesley So, Vocaturo doesn't play short castle, continues with the best move, that is queen to e7, a new protection on f7. Knight to e4 with the idea to jump and to win the important da square bishop, so to jump with check so that or black will not be able to castle or there is to exchange. So after knight to e4, it's time for black to really capture on e5. D capture, of course, now the pawn is lost, so there is no gain in recapturing. Bishop to g5 is attacking the queen that moves to b4 with check. c3, queen back to a5, so the queen is now adding a new protection to the pawn, but here comes bishop to f6. Better not to capture, or there is the problem that the king will remain not in the center, but the problem is that black will not be able to castle, not be able to connect the rooks. So after bishop to f6, now really it's time for short castle. It's white that capture on g7, the king recapture, the queen comes to f6 with check, and white regains the pawn. King back to g8. Queen captures on e5, the idea is really to change the queens and to play without the queens on the board. Queen captures, d captures, and in this position that is equal, the most played idea for black is bishop to d7, followed by bishop to c6, to give really a good diagonal to this light square bishop that now is behind this pawn chain. Another idea, the one played by Vocaturo, is knight to d7, attacking the pawn. So here comes f4, now a5, and now knight in b goes to e2. This move is a novelty because a4 or bishop back to c2 were played in the games that I have in my database. The game is now original and equal. Here comes a4 with tempo, bishop back to c2, and now knight to d5, attacking f4. g3 protecting the pawn, and here comes b5 that maybe is a bit too much. b6 is much safer, that still opens a good diagonal for the bishop. In this position, Wesley So continues with one of the best moves, that is king to f2. Let's go back one move. Now, in this position, it seems at first glance that c4 is an interesting move, with the idea to isolate these two pawns, but this idea doesn't work so well for white because the knight will jump to b4, attacking the unprotected bishop, and there is also the threat of, if the bishop moves to d1, of the knight jump we check, but bishop back to d1 is really the best move. The light square bishop will move to a6, then there is this knight jump we check, also b2 is under attack. It seems to me that there is a small advantage for black. So let's go back to our game. So that's why after b5, Wesley So continues with king to f2. Now bishop to b7, rook in h goes to e1, not only protecting the knight, but also protecting a possible knight jump in future to e3. Rook to a6 looks a bit strange, but what is the idea? I think that the idea is to play rook to b6, that will make two good things in one. Will support the queen side attack, because if black has time to play, this attack can be quite convincing for black. But at the same way, this rook will also protect this sixth rank. So that's why, in my opinion, the protection of the sixth rank is the reason why Vocaturo didn't play rook to b8 immediately, but liked more to bring the rook, yes, on the c5, but on c6. Yes, on the b5, but on b6. Let's go on with our game. Now, of course, Wesley So centralizes the second rook. Rook in a goes to d1, and now f6. E captures on f6. This is an important moment of the game because Vocaturo should immediately recapture with the knight on f6. Instead, he continues with e5, and this is not a great idea. Now, f captures on e5. The knight captures on e5, and knight jump to c5, also with the discovered attack, the position becomes very tactical. Now, of course, Vocaturo removes this knight that is under attack. Knight to g4 comes with check. King to g1 protecting the pawn. And now in this position, rook to a7 is the most accurate idea. Problem is that after rook to a7, white is better because the pieces are very well connected and these black pawns are weak. So, after king to g1, Vocaturo continues with knight in d goes to e3, one rook is under attack and also the bishop, knight captures on a6, and in this position, knight captures the bishop on c2. This is the best idea. Let's go back one move because regaining the e-change loses the game, because after knight capture on d1, the bishop recapturing is also attacking the unprotected knight, so black will regain one piece, but will lose another, and so, of course, the game is lost. Let's go back to our game. So, knight capture the bishop on c2, attacking the rook is the best idea. Wesley So moves the rook to e6, protecting the knight. Now, bishop back to c8, and this is another critical moment of the game. Because Wesley So, of course, and then let's remember, this is a rapid game, so there is not too much time to think. Of course, Wesley So doesn't want to lose the knight and continues with rook to c6. But the best idea is another one, quite complicated to find in a rapid game. Let's go back one move. The great idea is to play rook to e7. And why? Because if now black captures the knight, there is knight to e4, knight captures on f6, of course, the knight recapture, we check. The rook captures, and here comes rook to d8, we check. Problem is not the safety of the king, because the rook can simply move back, but the problem is that this knight is trapped. There is also c8 under attack. Notice that the knight with these two rooks on the central files can't move away. There is only one square, that is a1, and there is also c8 under attack, so better to at least protect c8. Now rook to e2, knight under attack, knight back to a1, the second rook comes to d1, and this endgame is lost for black. So fantastic idea, but let's go back to our game. After rook to c6, there is bishop to b7, again the rook is under attack, and Wesley So finds the good idea. Rook captures on c7, bishop captures on a6, knight to a4 is opening the d-file and also protecting the pawn. Now bishop back to c8, h3, knight to g3, attacking the rook and also protecting the knight, rook to d2, and now bishop captures on a3. But here comes the winning move, that is knight to g5, attacking h7 and also the unprotected bishop. Black can't allow that, so there is to remove the pawn, or the attack is winning. Rook captures on f6, and now rook to d8 we check. The rook must move back because this is the only move, and now rook captures on f8 we check to exchange the rooks. Finally, Wesley So regains the piece. Knight captures back on h3, and of course white has the advantage of the rook versus one knight. Knight to c4, the pawn is under attack, but the rook captures on f7. Knight captures on b2, this endgame of course is lost for black. Let's watch how Wesley So we win the game. Knight to f4, another pawn is under attack, here comes b4, there is to capture. C captures, knight captures, and now rook to b7. One knight will protect the other, but the problem is that there is also this other knight, so Wesley So simply continues with a3, everything is under attack, so black must change the knights. Knight capture, rook capture, also now this knight is under attack, must move away, moves away with check, king to g2, knight to c3, trying to protect the pawn, but the simple rook to c4, and this position, black resigns because the knight must move away, and also a4 is gone. There is rook versus knight and two pawns versus one, especially this one that is a far pass pawn. A very nice game in the Alekhine Defense, won by the great Wesley So. So if you are a fan of Wesley So, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and look in the playlist, because I have tons of Wesley So's victories in this channel. I hope in general that you like the game and these online Olympiads. If you do, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and to like the video. For now, thank you very much for watching, and see you soon with new games. Goodbye!